Yo, Adam Saxon with Guy in a Cuban. In this video, we are going to look at how we can add flexibility to our reports without overwhelming our users with a ton of visuals. Let's do this. If you're finding us for the first time, be sure to hit that subscribe button to stay up to date with all the videos from both Patrick and myself. All right, we've looked at the information panel. We've looked at ideas that can elevate our report. In this video, I want to dig in a little deeper and look at how do we actually give that flexibility to users to provide more insights and to be able to help answer their questions without cluttering the report page with a ton of visuals, which could also lead to performance problems. You guessed it. We're going to dive in a little more into more selections, bookmarks, and buttons. Oh my. Enough of all this talking. Let's head over to my machine and take a look. And we've got all these visuals, but maybe there's additional information that we can provide or give an option for someone to explore more data. So we've got our waterfall visual. We've got our matrix visual, and maybe we want to give them an option to maybe look at something else, but I don't have necessarily space on the report page to provide that, right? I've got everything laid out. It's clean, but I want to maybe give them something else. What I want to do is add a Dcom tree as part of this report page. So the way we're going to do it is let's go ahead and start by hiding these two visuals so that we've got room to actually create something. To do that, I'm on the View tab. We're going to open up Selections. I'm also going to open up Bookmarks because we're going to need that. Next, what we're going to do, we're going to hide these visuals. So if you're not sure which visual is because you didn't name them in a way that you can pick them out, just go ahead and select the visual and then it'll highlight it here on the selection bar. So I know that this one is here. And then the one that says Matrix for me is the Matrix. The Matrix, get it? Let's go ahead and hide that. So now we've got a clean slate. So what I want to do, and I'm not going to waste a whole lot of time with setting up the actual Dcom tree, like a good cooking show. I'm just going to paste that in. So here we go. Bam, we've got our Dcom tree. The other thing we're going to do is we're going to end up adding a button. So if you don't already have a button, you can go to insert, you can go to buttons. We can use the left arrow. We can use the back button. It doesn't really matter. You can pick whichever one you want. In this case, again, we've already got our button. I've already got it pre-set up to do hover effects and all of that. Again, I don't want to get into all of the details of setting those individual items up and formatting. Just know that you can add a button, you can format it. Same with the Dcom tree. Maybe that we could do for another video. So the big thing here is I've got my visuals here. So the return button is going to be part of the switch, right? So I want to go back to the waterfall visual and the matrix. What we can do here right now, if I do control click, it doesn't do anything because we got to wire this up. Now we know that the current state right now is what I want it to look like when we're in the Dcom tree. So we're going to add a bookmark at this point. However, before I actually create the bookmark, I want to get the other items lined up. And then once all the visuals are in place, then we're going to go create the bookmarks and I'll explain why in a minute. You'll see that I already have them named here, Dcom return button and then Dcom tree. So let me go ahead and hide those two and we're going to bring back our matrix and our waterfall visual. Then what I'm going to do is add another button. This button is what's actually going to get me into the Dcom tree. Again, if I click it, control click, if you're in desktop, regular click if you're in the service, it doesn't do anything because we don't have it wired up yet. So now I've got my two states. I've got when we're in our default view, and then we've got our visuals for when we're showing the Dcom tree. There are two items of the bookmarks that are going to be really important when we go and set this up. So one is going to be the data checkbox, and then the other one's going to be selected visuals. And you may be going like, wait, what? I've never even played around with that. If you're like me, I never did either until recently, and my mind was blown. So let's go ahead and look at that. Okay, so we're going to create our first bookmark. Everything's in the current state of when the Dcom tree is hidden. So what I need to do is I'm going to select all of the visuals involved in this operation. So there's five visuals total. So I'm going to select all of them in their current state. I'll select the waterfall, control click the matrix, and then Dcom tree, and then the two buttons. Then I'm going to create a bookmark and I'm going to call this hide Dcom tree. This is the state of when the Dcom tree is hidden. Next, what I'm going to do is on the ellipsis, I'm going to uncheck data because I don't want any of the filters or what applied from a bookmark perspective. Just leave those as is. The other thing I'm going to do, and this may be something that you've never paid attention to, by default, it's all visuals, which means the state of everything on the page is being saved with the bookmark. I only want it to save the selected visuals, and then that bookmark is ready to go. Next, I want to reverse everything, and I'm going to do the same thing. I'm going to select all five visuals because these are the ones that are part of the bookmark. Then what I'm going to do is going to add a new bookmark and call it Show Dcom Tree, right? I'm going to do the same thing. I'm going to uncheck data and I'm going to switch it to selected visuals. Now what we need to do is wire up the buttons. So we've got our bookmarks. So in the return on the action, I'm going to do Hide Dcom Tree. We'll do Control Click to take us back. That looks beautiful. Select the Dcom button, actions, bookmarks, and we're going to do Show Dcom Tree. And so now if I select it, bam, we see the Dcom Tree. If I go back to return, bam, there it is. We've got our switch of the visuals. I can now go from the matrix and waterfall to the Dcom Tree to give flexibility to those end users. The thing we want to be careful about when we're dealing with bookmarks are those options in the ellipsis, right? So the data, the state of which visuals are being selected. So those all play into that experience and you can do some amazing things with those. In this case, we use the power of those bookmarks and the different selections to do that swap without affecting anything else. This is just another solid example of how you can take your report to the next level to help them gain insights from their data in a powerful way because, you know, Power BI. All right, I want to hand this over to you. What do you think? Let me know in the comments if this blew your mind, if this is something you're already doing. I want to know. Also, put hashtag master bookmarks in the comments if you want me to dive into those little checkboxes on the bookmarks and demystify what they are all about. Happy to do that. If you like this video, be sure to hit the big thumbs up button. Smash it if you so desire. If it's your first time here, hit that subscribe button. And as always, from both Patrick and myself, thank you so much for watching. Keep being awesome, and we'll see you in the next video.